Welcome to the Spy Collection Digital Edition, where we are looking at spy artifacts that only exist in digital format. I'm Anastasios, and in this episode we'll look into a document from 2011 that was part of the files that Edward Snowden shared with journalists in 2013. Eventually, it was published in 2015 by The Intercept. This document was produced by the Access Strategy team of the British GCHQ and gives a rare glimpse into the work that SIGINT agencies do to hack into commercially available hardware. In this case, it was about Juniper Networks, an American multinational company that is one of the leaders in the market of network appliances such as routers, firewalls, switches, and so on, that many companies and telecommunication providers are relying on. As per its executive summary, Juniper Networks Incorporated, headquartered in Sunnyvale, California, USA, is a high-performance internet protocol network products company. Juniper's main products include T-Series, M-Series, E-Series, MX-Series, J-Series, families of routers, EX-Series, Ethernet switches, and NetScreen and SRX-Series security products. Next, we read, while Juniper is not necessarily the market share leader in any one space, they are a strong competitor and technology leader across several important markets from a SIGINT perspective. Juniper is at the core of the internet in many countries by virtue of providing the highest density routers for many years. And Juniper's leadership in core IP routing and the enterprise network firewall and SSL VPN markets means that the SIGINT community should keep up with Juniper technology to be positioned to maintain computer network exploitation access over time. In other words, GCHQ wanted to ensure that they'll maintain means to hack into Juniper network appliances so that they can spy on any of their targets if they happen to rely on Juniper devices. Next, we read what GCHQ was then able to covertly compromise from Juniper's product line. Juniper NetScreen firewall models NS5GT, N25, NS50, NS500, NS204, NS208, NS5200, NS5000, SSG5, SSG20, SSG140, ISG1000, ISG2000. Some reverse engineering may be required depending on firmware revisions. And Juniper routers M320 is currently being worked on, and we would expect to have full support by the end of 2010. This is one of the most controversial topics in modern SIGINT, that spy agencies intentionally hide flaws in devices used by thousands, hundreds of thousands, or even millions of people in order to be able to use them to hack into their targets. So the same applies here too. The above vulnerabilities that GCHQ was exploiting might have been used by others too, for purposes such as cybercrime, hacktivism, or cyber attacks. Continuing through the document, we read recommendations and expected outcomes. Discover Juniper equipment on networks in hard target countries to assess potential Juniper exploitation opportunities with existing capabilities. Assess potential additional targetable networks if additional equipment modules could be exploited, e.g., if we could exploit MX series routers, then networks X, Y, and Z could be exploited. Assess an effort to exploit JUNOS operating system. Regarding the last point, JUNOS is Juniper Networks' custom operating system that their appliances are using. Next, we have an answer into how Edward Snowden had access to this GCHQ document. That document was produced specifically for sharing between GCHQ and the NSA, and its originator was an NSA integree to GCHQ's Access Strategy team. Note that the name of the NSA employee was redacted by the journalists before releasing this document. Then we have the table of contents and the history of Juniper. Feel free to pause the video if you'd like to read those. And here we have a summary of the different product lines that Juniper was offering in 2010 to 2011. And some additional information on the company strategy and structure. All of them are available since they show us how SIGINT agencies see private companies as targets, or more precisely, as potential new intelligence collection capabilities, and the work they are doing to formalize this. Next, we have an interesting segment that we'll read. It says, While Juniper is not necessarily the market share leader in any one space, they are a strong competitor and technology leader across several important markets from a SIGINT perspective. Juniper is at the core of the internet in many countries by virtue of providing the highest density routers for many years. As telecommunications service providers move toward all IP networks, Juniper will play an increasingly central role in converged networks. Juniper has proven adept at leveraging their high-density server technology to challenge market leaders in both the edge server and enterprise network firewall markets. In another somewhat niche market, but one that is very important to SIGINT, Juniper is viewed as the ablest competitor selling SSL VPN technology. Well-established position in the carrier space with high-density routers. Credible competitive alternative to Cisco dominance of core routing. Carrier Ethernet growing in volume and scope. IP traffic growth continues unabated. And next, let's read how a private company selling network appliances could be seen as a threat by a spy agency like Britain's GCHQ. Juniper's leadership in core IP routing and the enterprise network firewall and SSL VPN markets means that the SIGINT community should keep up with Juniper technology to be positioned to maintain CNE access over time. The threat comes from Juniper's investment and emphasis on being a security leader. If the SIGINT community falls behind, it might take years to regain a Juniper firewall or router access capability if Juniper continues to rapidly increase their security. This is a key part for everyone interested in the intelligence space, as well as privacy. For spy agencies, companies investing in protecting their customers, partners, and employees are seen as a threat since it makes it harder to spy on them. This is common sense among people in the espionage world, but many people, even to this day, fail to recognize this. Then we read a quick summary of some key targets of GCHQ that were using Juniper devices that they could potentially compromise to spy on them. Global IP networks. Juniper core routers can be found throughout the internet and all other high-capacity IP networks. Examples are too numerous to cite. A flag telecom case study is available as an example. Pakistan. Juniper firewalls are central to the very high-priority Headress NU project targeting a Pakistan government military secure network. While the core internet routers in Pakistan are all Cisco, Juniper is often seen as an edge router on networks connected to the core. Juniper routers are deployed in the Mobilink network and possibly Telenor. Afghanistan. No evidence of Juniper presence. CT broker. Although Juniper has been mentioned in connection with a broker target on a number of occasions, the only evidence that has been seen is of a Juniper router being used in a small-scale trial that wasn't taken any further. CT, Yemen. Juniper provides security hardware for the Yemen Telecom and a firewall for Tele Yemen's voice over IP connection to Verizon. CT, Saudi Arabia. And then, China. Juniper have a strong presence in China through Juniper Networks China Limited, based in Hong Kong. A Jiangxi e-government case study is available as an example. A press release is included below as another example of Juniper in China. Then we have a summary about how Juniper Networks routing platforms form core of China's next-generation internet, followed by the current and planned work to exploit Juniper. Here's what's important to note in this last bullet point where it says, Juniper technology sharing with NSA improved dramatically during 2010 to exploit several target networks where GCHQ had access primacy. This is important to remember for members of alliances like the Five Eyes. There is such strong collaboration that includes sharing hacking tools as we read here. And the assessment was that the ability to exploit Juniper servers and firewalls will pay many dividends over the years. Juniper is already a major hardware provider across the internet today. With the growth of converged IP networks and Juniper's technology leadership, we should expect Juniper opportunities to grow significantly over the next several years. Juniper is a strong competitor to Cisco when a buyer seeks an alternative supplier who is also a technology leader. Huawei is another competitor in the same space, But when a buyer seeks a lower-cost alternative supplier, Juniper carries a potential opportunity and complication by being a US company. There is potential to leverage a corporate relationship should one exist with NSA. In other words, this is telling us that the NSA could try to get Juniper to intentionally weaken the security of their devices, install backdoors for them, or other means to facilitate their mission. Continuing, any GCHQ efforts to exploit Juniper must begin with close coordination with NSA. The Juniper family of products are somewhat homogeneous in their use of the JUNOS operating system. This could create opportunities to exploit security vulnerabilities in JUNOS and extrapolate them to a wider range of Juniper routing product lines. And here we read what GCHQ was planning on doing following this assessment by their access strategy team. EWAT, exploit what's available today. Capture existing opportunities. Document current capabilities to exploit Juniper equipment. Discover Juniper equipment on networks in hard target countries, potential Juniper exploitation opportunities. Validate potential Juniper exploitation opportunities against 1. Fit with current Juniper exploit capabilities. 2. Target-centric evaluation of potential intelligence benefit. Impact assessments against validated Juniper exploitation opportunities and business decision to pursue or not. Expand Juniper exploit capabilities, create future opportunities, discover Juniper equipment on networks in hard target countries, potential Juniper exploitation opportunities, assess potential additional targetable networks if additional equipment models could be exploited, assess potential intelligence benefit if additional networks could be exploited, impact assessments of creating exploits of additional Juniper models, and JUNOS exploitation. The vast majority of current Juniper exploits are against firewalls running the ScreenOS operating system. Juniper will migrate all products to the JUNOS operating system over time. An effort to ensure exploitation capability of JUNOS should bear fruit against a wide range of Juniper products. That concludes our overview of this rare and insightful GCHQ digital artifact, which practically showed us how modern SIGINT strategic planning looks like, how Five Eyes spy agencies collaborate for hacking capabilities, and more importantly, how spy agencies perceive private companies that are trying to secure their products and services. Apparently, publicly no spy agency will say that this is how they see the world. But as we know, nothing is as it seems.